On our previous King Legacy video, we decided to level up a noob account, level 1, and unlock gear 4th. And we've gained lots of views, 70k views. So I decided to make a part 2. We are going to level this up from 1,000 to 3,200. So this video will be a guide. Are you ready, guys? Let's go!
Where the Echo Slam!
Oh, there it is!
Dancing forward! There's your slam! There's the dunk!
Hello, GamerNom is back. So for this video, again, we are going to continue this level 1000 Gum Gum Fruit Gear 4th unlock. So if you weren't able to watch it, I'll put the link on the upper right side of the screen. Okay, so we can still train here with a Ballman, but reaching level 1000 means you can now train on the next island, which is the Bubble Island. Go. Okay, here we are again, level 1000. We are gonna start with 5 soldiers. So how do you defeat this? The fastest way, okay, you need to defeat 3 mobs using your C skill. There you go. And you can now use your first and your second skill to kill the 2 remaining soldiers. Okay, and that's it, guys. That's how you finish this quest. So you just need to keep on doing this until you reach level 1100. Okay, I'm just gonna show you how should you grind this properly to make everything faster. So first and second skill, C skill, you need to defeat 3. There you go. And that's it for the quest, okay? Again, reach 1,100 with that. Now you can start defeating the leader, okay? So this leader can be defeated by just using your C skill. But guys, is there a faster way? There is. The spawn time of this leader is kinda long, so what should you do? You should defeat this fast. Okay, guys, you can also defeat this by using first and second skill as long as your power foot is enough. After defeating it, get this quest, okay? Use your first, your second, and your C skill. Fast, guys, fast. Okay, E, there you go, or use Zoro and defeat this, okay? So now you are defeating 2 mobs at the same time and you will level up fast. When you reach level 1150, you can now start defeating Pacifista. Guys, you don't need to like defeat other mobs because the spawn time of this mob is very fast. So after you defeat this, it will spawn automatically or really, really fast, okay? So when you reach level 1250, we can now train in the Lobby Island. So here you go. You will start defeating the wolf. So it's very easy. Just use your C skill or your first and second and that will be enough, okay? Again, guys, patience on leveling up. After this, after reaching level 1325, you can now start defeating the giraffe. Guys, in this mob, use your second and first skill. Don't use your C skill because it will teleport to you and it might damage or use some of your observation haki points, right? Again, we have 8. So, is there a fast way? Yes. After defeating this, you can use your E, fly towards the wolf, and defeat it, okay? You can do that to level up fast. And when you reach level 1400, you can now start defeating Leo. Okay, there you go, Roblucci. Guys, if you really want to make it faster, go back to other mobs, but I don't suggest that. Just rest with this boss, okay? So when you reach level 1500, everything will be a lot faster now. Zombie Island. So here you go. Defeat 5 zombies. How do you defeat them? Just lure. Okay, lure 4, there you go, and when they're near, use your C skill. I suggest don't use your shift lock, there you go, that's it. After that, lure them again back towards the quest giver and get the quest and defeat 4, okay? That's how you do it, fast. Do this until you reach level 1600, but GamerNom, again, I'm in the public server, I get bullied a lot. I'm just not showing it to you. So after reaching 1600, you can now start defeating the Shadow Master. Guys, I saw a comment, how do you defeat this? It's very easy. First skill, X, and jump, jump, and then first skill. That's it, and fly. Okay, go around, and there you go. Why did you do that, GamerNom? To avoid the hit of the Dark Master, okay, the Shadow Master. Again, first skill. Oh, sorry, jump, jump, jump. Okay, X, and Z skill. And E, go around again. Why? If you stay on the ground, you will get damage, okay? When you reach level 1800, you can now go to the War Island and start defeating rare admirals. Guys, Why 1,800, guys? Because it's the requirement. So if you have the poll, I got this from, there you go, the Rumble Man. You can lure easier. There you go, first, second, and another first. There you go. And you can use your C skill. If you don't have it, you can just punch it. Okay, punch dodge. Same on what I did with the zombies in the zombie island. There you go. You just need to do it 50 times, okay? For 50 level ups. So that you can proceed to the next mob. Okay? Okay. There you go. So, when you reach 1,850, you can now start defeating this. The true karate fishman. So guys, how do you defeat this faster? If you use the C skill, it's enough. But to dodge it, go sideways. Okay? Sideways or something like that. Okay? Can you see what I'm doing? There you go. Now, when you reach 1,925, you can start defeating this, the Quake Woman. Okay, so it's kind of easy. Just use C-Skill. You can use your Observation Haki. There you go. Guys, the wave, you can dodge it by using Soro, okay? The moment it hits you. So when you reach 2,050, you can now go to the final island and first see the Fisherman Island, the Mermaid Island, or whatever. Okay. So we start here, 2050, and defeat this mob, okay, the combat fishman, and you're gonna do it until you reach 2100. Gamernom, you are escaping quests again. Yes, why? Because I prefer defeating single mob quests compared to luring, because it really is, it really needs extra patience, and it is kinda longer, okay? So when you reach 2200, you can now defeat the seasoned fisherman. Guys, it's kind of hard, to be honest, because it will really hit you, but you just need to be patient. Again, remember, this is the last mob in the second sea, so it should be challenging, okay? And by the way, the second time that I defeated this, I got a drop, the map, okay? So some of you might be asking, Gamernom, you can start the quest at 1,500, but what's the use? We're not gonna train there yet. But I accidentally got the map, so I did the War Island quest again. Talk to this dude, he will ask you to find a map. See that? Good luck. But I already have the map, so just talk to him again. And there you go, you can now go to second sea. But we will not go there because we're gonna level up in the first sea again. This is a guide, guys. Follow this to make everything faster, okay? I did this one day from level 1000 to 3200. Okay, so do this, defeat this boss until you reach 2350. Guys, check this out. Check the XP, it says only 31,000, but no, you will still level up. See that? One mob, one level up. So when you reach 2,350, off to the second sea. Okay. Guys, just a tip on the second sea, always party people, okay? Guys, this is the quest that we skip. Check this out, they're so far apart. Yes, you can lure them. Okay, lure 1, lure 2, 3, and 4. But guys, think of it, you only have one enemy. Go, second skill, third skill, and done. See this? Think of it. You're just luring this. 1, 2, 3, 4. See that? Okay. So long. We've already defeated 2 mobs, right? 2 quests. See that, guys? That's so slow. Okay? Okay, so this is where you level up. Start in the Fauns land. Make sure to save there. Okay, so we're gonna start here. Okay, the Snake Man, 2,350 quest. Second skill, third skill, and it's done. Guys, no luring needed, right? This is faster. Trust me. You're gonna do this until you reach 2,500. Again, we're gonna skip a quest. Why? Because again, it requires you to defeat 4, 5, or 6 mobs. It's longer, blah, blah, blah. Okay? Okay. So, upon reaching that, go to the next area, the Hibernus Land, and defeat the Violet Samurai. Again, is it hard? No. X skill, C skill. Guys, you noticed, in the second C, you cannot defeat them with only one skill. You need 2 skills. So, second and third. See that, guys? Easy. Do this until you reach 2,550. And you can now go to the next leveling area, the Floresco. Okay? So here, you can start defeating the Rabbit Man. Guys, in this area, there are so many players passing by. Because this is the main road, so make sure to look on the other side and check if someone is trying to defeat you. Okay? To get bounty from you. So do this again until you reach 2,600, okay? Okay, so upon reaching that, Oh, by the way, I got the saber. Okay, 2,600, you can now start defeating the Batman. Kind of familiar. Okay, so after defeating this, sure, this is kind of easy. Second skill, and you can use first skill. Again, there are lots of bullets in this area because it's very near near the save point. Okay, so after reaching 2,650, you can now start defeating this. The samurai. The kitsune samurai. Second skill, third skill is enough. But take note, this is the last boss that you can defeat by just using two skills. Okay? So when you reach 2,800, Corsair, this dude is kind of strong, the bear man. You need three skills. The first, the Z. The second, the X skill. And the third, the C skill. Okay? Again, you always use gear 4th, Snake Man, and all the mobs. Okay, so when you reach 2,900, guys, we are so near, right? Gamer Gnome, you make it look easy. Guys, the technique here, be patient all the time. If someone messages seeking or someone tries to bully you, don't give them time or attention, okay? Just continue leveling up, change servers. Level 2,900 is the patchy woman, right? There you go. Kinda easy to defeat, but there's a high chance that it will damage you or teleport to you, but it's fine, guys. 2,900, 300 levels to go. Easy. Upon reaching level 2,150, off to the next area again. Last three mobs. Gamer Gnome, last three, there are other mobs like the Anubis, etc. Guys, you don't need to do that. We're talking about leveling up, okay? This is the fastest way, aside from someone helping you. This is a solo guide. Next, go to Viridans and defeat the Kappa. It's on the left side, okay? Okay, so if you're wondering, Gamer Gnome, is the gear 4th enough? Yes, guys, yes. The stats, max power fruit, okay? 4,000. So, Z, X, and C skill is enough, okay? So, keep on doing this until you reach level 3,000. Gamer Gnome, is it that easy? Yes. Avoid doing the Sea Beast, the Enma, and Kaido quest, the ore, and that's enough, guys. I promise. Don't mind them, the bullies, etc. Just keep on grinding. One day is enough. That's including the rest, the breakfast, lunch, and dinner, etc. And the nap. I took a nap. Okay, so when you reach level 3,775, okay, 3,075. You can now go to the last area where we're gonna level up, okay? Again, this is not the last area of the game. The leveling area only. This looks familiar, right? You're gonna defeat the mob where you can get the ore to summon Kaido, the dragon. And it's kinda easy. Why? Two things. Aside from it really is easy, there are lots of players grinding in this area. So make sure to ally them. Check this out. Thank you, dude. They allied me, so everything's really easier. Just one skill, okay? And that's enough to level up, okay? So do this until you reach 3,200. It's very easy, guys. You just need time and patience. Gamer, can you defeat it solo? I have a VIP server, example, something like that. Yes, there you go. You can defeat it solo, just two skills. It's enough. See that, guys? Two skills, okay? Okay, so that will be it. Again, I'm gonna post a King Legacy video. Level 1 noob. I'm thinking of Magma or Light or the Snow or Rumble. So comment it in the comment section. What fruit do you want me to level up again from level 1 noob to the second C? Okay? So again, to all the viewers, subscribers, supporters, I appreciate you all. This is Gamer Gnome, and Gamer Gnome out.